Visit us at Eduvvo. Thank you for calling Eduvvo.
Make your app more visually appealing and interesting, and they're super easy to add in Android Studio. So let's just start by grabbing a couple of images. I'm a big fan of cats, so I'm going to go for a couple of cat images. There we go, lovely. Worth saying at this point that if you want to use an actual image that you find on the web in one of your real apps, then you should make sure that copyright of the image allows you to. But if you're just using images to test your apps for yourself, then you can use any that you like. So I'm going to take this one and control click and save image to downloads. Notice this image is pretty big, 2500 by 2500. So I'm actually going to jump over to the Finder and just edit the image to bring it down to a smaller size so that we won't have any problems with our app running out of memory when it tries to load the image. On Mac, this is pretty easy. You can just double click on the image to open it in preview and then click Tools, Adjust Size, and then I'm going to change to pixels and we'll change it to about 500. That'll be plenty for our purposes. And then save and close that down. And next we'll have, this one here looks quite adorable. So again, control click. This one's a much smaller image. So we'll use it in its present form. I'm just going to rename those to cat1 and cat2. Notice they're different types. We've got a JPEG and a PNG file. Both of those will load fine within your Android apps. You don't need to convert them to a specific type. All right, so now back over to Android Studio. And to bring in our images, we bring back our project structure. And you may remember the resources folder. That's where we're going to put our images. So just open it up and then open up the drawable folder. And that's where we'll drag our images into. Now, if you're running Windows, you can just select both of those and drag them straight into the drawable folder. But on Mac, unfortunately, that doesn't work. You have to do a slightly more complicated process. Command C to copy to the clipboard and then click on the drawable folder and then Command V to paste. And then click OK, copy the files, and there they are. So now we can use cat1 and cat2 in our app, and adding them is pretty straightforward. We go back over to our layout, so activitymain.xml, and again, we've got a list of our widgets. I can't see image there, so I'm just going to click on the search button and type image, and there we go. We want image view. We don't need our image to be a button. So let's bring in our image. There we go. And we can choose an image right there that we want to use for it. So I'll go for cat1 for now. Click OK. And there it is. Simple as that. Let's just give ourselves a bit more room. The only thing we'll want to be aware of is how to lay out our image. So at the moment, it's a little bit off the edge of the screen. So of course, you can resize and add margins in exactly the same way that you would any other element. Just going to drag it back in. There we go. The only thing I want to bring to your attention here is the scale type, which offers a variety of different ways of squeezing your image into the image view container. So you can try those out. They're all reasonably self-explanatory. Probably fit center is going to be most likely what you want. That will fit it and center it so it'll be as large as possible, but you'll be able to see the whole image within the box. There we go. All right, so that's how you add images to your apps. Super easy. But of course, I want to give you a bit of a challenge to practice this, and it's going to extend your skills a little bit as well. So what we're going to make is this. Now, on the surface, it looks like just the image of our cat, but it does something a little bit special. And that is when we tap the button, it changes the image to our second cat. And that's why we downloaded two cat images in the first place. So to complete this challenge, you're going to need to do a little bit of Googling online to find how you update the image within an image view using code when a button is pressed. So that'd be a good bit of practice for you, finding solutions to coding problems online. One other small thing that you might come across is aligning this button at the bottom right there. That's not quite as easy as it might seem. I'll give you a little hint. I'd recommend looking in all attributes and then look at the constraint options and play around with a few of those and see if you can make the button align to the bottom right of the screen. Okay, so a little bit more than the usual challenge here. Sure you'll rise to it. Best of luck. All right, hope that went well. Here we go. So I'm going to start a new project. I'm going to call it Cat Switcher. Next, and all the default options. Again, having done this 4 or 5 times should be pretty straightforward for you. And here we go. So let's begin by bringing our images into our apps. We know how to do that now. So just select them in the Finder or Windows Explorer and then paste into the drawable folder. Oh, we're not quite ready yet. Try again. There we go. All right, so we've got our images. Now, I'm going to get rid of Hello World. Search for my image view. And then drag it in. And we'll start off with Cat 1. And then switch to Cat 2. There we go. So I'm going to try and make it full screen. Lovely. And we'll set the scale type, as we did before, to fit center. And we'll just set the margins as well. So it will be full screen on any device. I'll change the ID to cat image view, so that we know which image view we're talking about, even though we've only got one. And then we just need a button to be our switcher. And we'll put the button on top of the image, the bottom right of the screen. And I'll call it cat switcher button. And on click, in a minute, I'll create the method switch cat. Okay. Now we're going to go over and write some code. One habit that I think it's worth getting into is just running your app as soon as you've created the layout. That just means that all the setup can be done while you're writing some code, and then it's much quicker to run it when you're actually ready to test it out. All right, so let's write our method called switchCat. As we're used to, it's going to be a public method that doesn't return anything. It's called switchCat, and it accepts a variable of a type view with a capital V. Alt enter to add the view class. And that variable will be called view with a little v. And for now, we'll just do a quick log. To let us know that the button has been pressed. Okay, let's check our app. Oh, and we've got a bit of an issue there. The button is at the top left and we want it at the bottom right. So let's just see how we're going to achieve that. As is often the case, there's a number of different ways of doing it, but the way I'm going to show you is the way I use most often, and that is to look at the more advanced constraints list in the attributes list. And then we want the bottom of the button to be aligned to the bottom of this box here, which is our constraint layout, which is the parent element of the button. So that will now align the button to the bottom of the parent element. And we also want the right of the button to be aligned to the right of the parent element. There we go. That should do it. If you want to add in a bit of a margin, just so that it's not completely at the bottom right, then you can do that as well. Maybe 10. Okay. Just going to run that again just to be sure that the button is now displaying where we want it to be. It looks like with those arrows that we have set up the constraints correctly. Let's find out. And there we go. Wonderful. So I hope you managed to solve that some way or other. As we've written our code already, we should be able to tap the button and get a response in the log. So let's have a look. Yep. Brilliant. Okay, so all that remains is to work out how to switch the image from the first cat to the second using the button. And as I suggested earlier, I'm going to do a quick Google search to see if we can find a solution to this. Now, when you're searching for Android development code, I normally put both Android and Java at the beginning of my search, and then I'll go for something like update image dynamically. Dynamically implies that we want to do it automatically using code. There we go. That top result takes us to a website called Stack Overflow. If you're a seasoned coder, you've doubtless gone to Stack Overflow many, many times. If you're not, then get used to it. It's a really great site where people answer each other's questions, and it almost always appears at the top of Google when you search for a coding question like we just did. Okay, so looking at the top answer here, this looks to be exactly what we want. So it's worth taking a moment to make sure that the code does what we think it does. So we're creating an image view variable called image, which is of a type image view and finds the image view that's already in place. Great, we've got one of those. And then it just sets the image resource to a specific resource inside the drawable resources area. Looks pretty perfect. So let's copy that with Control C. And then paste it into our code. We'll need Alt Enter to get the image view class. And of course, we'll need to update the code to make sure it works with our own app. We don't have an image view called test image. We have an image view called, or with an ID of, cat image view. So let's update that to cat image view. There we go. And then we want to set the image resource. We don't have a image resource called XXX. Our one is called cat2. And there we go. So that should update our image view from cat1 to cat2. Let's take a look. Tap the button, and there we go. Fantastic. So I hope you figured out how to do that yourself. If you didn't, don't worry. Early days yet. You'll definitely get the hang of searching online for solutions to programming problems. All right, so now we've mastered images, we're going to build our